All right, what do they say? The third time's a charm. How about the 10th time or the 15th time, the 20th time being a charm? This new YouTube, they changed the webcam format a little bit, webcam recording, and it's not working very good at all. Either the video does not process, or the audio is all messed up, or it disconnects. It's just amazing, tremendously buggy right now. Everything about technology is very buggy right now, so I've been recording many satsangs, and none of them have uploaded properly. So, what to do? Keep on trying to do shorter ones. We know that it's a Wednesday evening. We know tomorrow morning, sometime Thursday, the Supreme Court is going to pass down a decision. And no matter which way it goes, you know, there's going to be a lot of very unhappy people, a lot of agitation. So, we need to turn to the sovereign remedy for all agitation. What is that? Experiencing unconditional love. And we need to ask ourselves why we haven't done that. And we need to see if we can get a clear picture of where is our reluctance coming from. Now, in the videos that have not failed to upload, I have pointed out extremely important area that and I've linked it to the times that we live in. We need to address the reluctance, the soup du jour, the reluctance of the day. Where is it coming from? And it's coming from high technology. And it's coming from high technology because we are experiencing of that. High technology has built in a substratum of paranoia, fear, distrust, because we know everything that we're doing is being monitored, is being logged as data. The database is being collected. Every website we visit, every YouTube video we click on, every login that we do, every logout that we do, everything is being collected in a database about us and is being used by various people, being sold, being given here. And we don't trust high technology for very good reason. Also, it's very fragile. Just the computer, at least 15 times just this afternoon. Continuing problem with drivers not being able to record. It's just amazing the troubles I've had. Very fragile, all sorts of problems occur all the time. Constantly collecting data on us, and doing all sorts of shitty things. We know that this high technology and the people who brought it are very questionable people with questionable motives and questionable agendas, to say the very least. In fact, you might say they're the opposite of unconditional love. And herein lies our key to salvation, is that unconditional love collects no data on us whatsoever. And matter of fact, it's incapable of collecting any data on us. It is literally data-free. And when we experience unconditional love, we are experiencing a data-free condition. And that's a big wow, right, for most of us. All of us in this world right now, actually, because the whole world's been contaminated with the distrust and paranoia and deep-seated fears about technology. What is it really, where is it coming from, what's its purpose, where is the direction that it's aiming us in, where is it pushing us towards, what are its demands? I was in a store today, and we've had an account there for a long, long time, and our account suddenly didn't show up on the computer. And they said, oh, you don't have an account with us, you're not on the computer. And I said, what are you talking about? And they said, well, we have no history of you ever being here. And I said, I've been here hundreds of times. What are you talking about? And they said, well, we don't have any history of you being here. And I'm talking to the same person that I've interacted with hundreds of times, and they're acting like they don't even know who I am. They said, you're not on the computer. We don't have any history of you being here. I just said, wow, how incredible is that? Another human being that you've interacted with hundreds of times is saying that you don't exist for them. You're not on the computer. As far as they're concerned, you've never been here. You have no history. Talk about dehumanizing, right? And that's, you know, is a shocking thing. Shocking thing. I go into another store where I've been tens of thousands of times, and they're told you're supposed to ID people with accounts, and they say, can I see your ID? And I say, you know who I am. I've been here, you know, you've seen me thousands and thousands of times. And yet they still say, well, we have to ask you for ID. You know, again, very dehumanizing. So the whole world is being dehumanized. It used to be, you know, we had relationships. We knew who we were. We didn't ask for someone's identification. Went to a bank. The bank teller's been there for 20 years. They know your family. They know your kids. They know your business. They know everything. And how you're doing. And they trust you. There's trust. They understand. Now you go in. They don't know who you are. And where's your ID? All this kind of stuff. So we are in a situation where our trust and faith is evaporating. Like water in a hot desert, and we're paranoid about our culture, our society, where we're headed, and we realize everything we do online and anywhere, credit cards, everything, is being collected. Why? You see why? Unconditional love knows who we are. It knows that God created us as spirit. And it knows that what we are is imperishable, invulnerable, eternal, and we can never be disqualified from what we are. And the game of forgetfulness that we're playing in regards to our identity, which is what existence is, a game of forgetfulness, has no bearing on what we are whatsoever, has no effect on it. So it, unconditional love, knows who we are. It doesn't need to ask us for any papers, any identification. It can never forget what we are. It doesn't need to know when we log on or log off. It just simply is. It's just available, perfectly available to us every single moment. And it's impossible for us to be disqualified in any way from having perfect access to unconditional love. We can experience it this very moment, any moment. And should we choose to drop away from the experience, there's no data on that whatsoever. Unconditional love doesn't judge in any, completely judgment-free, completely data-free. So we need to take a moment here just to let that sink in, that there is data-free experience for us, for all of us. It doesn't matter how many billions of bits of data that may have been collected on us by the external world. Unconditional love has zero bits of data on us. Zero, because it knows from the very beginning, it's perfectly certain of what we are. Already knows. We're already pre-qualified to experience unconditional love and remember what we are. The ego's plan of salvation is to forget what we are, to perfectly forget what we are. God's plan of salvation is to perfectly remember what we are. Unconditional love, responding to unconditional love, is the means to remember what we are. The ego and all its efforts is trying to drive us over some abyss of perfect forgetfulness of what we are, which will never work, because we are eternal in the mind of God. Prime Creator is eternal. We are the prime creation of the prime creator. We are eternal. We will always be what we are. So we cannot perfectly forget what we are. Because God knows what we are. And God establishes what we are. We don't establish what we are. We're established. What we are is established by the Prime Creator. The Prime Creator, all of creation is one. Nothing can be forgotten in creation. It's all one. So the ego's plan will never work. We can never perfectly forget what we are. We can only be in a state of forgetfulness of what we are. But we can never perfectly forget what we are. The ego believes if we do this, magically we will be prime creators of a new reality. This is all just fantasy. It will never happen. So really our only path there is the option of remembering what we are. It's the only option we have. When we choose to exercise this option, it's up to us. As I said before, we can respond to unconditional love and then back away from it if we want to. And there's no accounting for that. Unconditional love does not have any accounting department. No judgment department. no data department. It doesn't have any departments. It's not a corporation. It's not a business. It's not a government. It's not a bureaucracy. There's zero bureaucracy. There's no politicians. There's no lawyers there. There's no Supreme Court there. There's no decisions being rendered. None. It already knows who we are, what we are, and it's just perfectly reminding us of that by being perfectly steady, unmodifiable, perfectly still, exactly what it is, unchanging, unchanging, no modification. It's the effect that is unmodifiable, and by us responding to this effect, we remember what we are, because what we are cannot be changed or modified either. As we look at this world, everything is being changed and modified. That causes forgetfulness, a state of forgetfulness of what we are. A forgetting, a state of forgetting. Not perfect forgetfulness, but a state of forgetting that's temporary. So, responding to unconditional love. Unconditional love gives us the means to respond to it also. It's not our senses that are responding to it. It provides the means to respond to it. But we're afraid. We say, well, you know, maybe it'll collect data on when I logged in and when I logged out. Maybe it's going to judge me and report, keep a database, and I'm not ready yet. You know, I'm afraid I might make mistakes, and so I don't. I might be disqualified, you know, so we hesitate. We say, first we have to be perfect before we do this. No, that is the great mistake we make. Because as I said before, unconditional love is completely non-judgmental. Has no accounting, collects no data on us. Therefore, there's nothing to fear. It will never collect data on anyone. It's data-free. 100% data free, always will be 100% data free. What a refreshment that is, isn't it? What a great escape that is, isn't it? What a sovereign remedy that is, isn't it? And let us see if YouTube can actually deal with this recording. All right, that's it.